everything
out of him.
No, maybe because, you know, the headquarters of our movie industry now is Kumasi.
No, you see.
We didn't try. The people in charge, they didn't
maybe,
try for us.
Maybe.
They didn't try for us. Yeah, anyway.
I'm sure, you know, Juliet will have some more explanation to this matter.
No, it's not Juliet's fault, too.
It's not her fault.
But what I mean is that, I mean, she herself, she's doing her best.
Yeah, because they made an approach. Uh-huh. And apparently they were told also quite late that the man was coming. Anyway, ECG,
let's go.
They owe money. They are collecting money. They owe money. From IPP, go and disconnect ECG. IPP, go and disconnect ECG. Anyway, on a more serious note, Daily Graphics front page says Power Production in danger. ECG owes IPPs $1.4 billion.
Wow.
That's a lot of money.
That is.
Four parties kick against overhaul of constitution. Tackling violent extremism requires collective response. President Akufo-Addo at the UN Security Council. And then there's a feature today, Constituency Watch, Nalarugu Gambaga constituency, home of scenic tourist sites.
Let me take you to the Ghanaian Times. The big story says parts of country to face a 14-day power interruption as Atuabo gas plant shuts down for maintenance. Why not just say Doomsaw returns as Atuabo?
It's Doomsaw.
Who can manage the Doomsaw like that? You know, it saves them all of us, all the words. Also, we are told NIA begins distributing backlogged 541,529 Ghana cards Wednesday. Also, MP urges president to ratify amended suicide act. This is coming in from the Honorable Bernard Ahiafo, who is a member of parliament for the Akachi South constituency. And then also some 1.2 million Ghana Cedi power theft is reported here. And three ECG workers, seven others have been busted for allegedly stealing and then also engaging in money laundering. Some other stories on the front page.
Front page of the Republic Press, they go with Atu Forsen and they say his woe's not over. Directed to open defense in ambulance trial. The ECG stories on the front page. Please grab social media desperados. Good one. China proposes global civilization initiative to strengthen cultural cooperation. And good news from the NIA, Sky. Mm-hmm. Over 500,000 Ghana cards ready to be distributed.
Solid. The Finder says this morning, 2022, Jubilee House had 361 political appointees. 163 worked physically at the presidency and 198 worked with other state agencies. Assembly. Also, MPP flag bearer race. Baumia must win. Campaign launched. Also, ministry denies politicizing road allocations and pension scheme may be cancelled with change in government. According to Cuckoo Farmers.
Front page of the Ghanaian publisher, Baumia best for NPP, according to a group. I think yesterday there was something that happened. we'll get details about that. Akufo-Addo submits staff list to parliament. That also caused a bit of an uproar yesterday. And Amidu backs judge in Anas Ken, 25 million Ghana Cedi case.
The Ghanaian Observer says Baumia's competence, sacrifices, and loyalty make him the best to lead the MPP, according to a group. Also, integrated aluminium industry progressing, according to the Lands Minister, John Jinapo.
Mm-hmm.
And the story also is here about the Vice President commissioning multipurpose technology hub. And Akufo-Addo tasks UN to prioritize fight against terrorism and violent extremism.
Front page of the Chronicle newspaper, they go with Uncle Atu's story. He has a case to answer. Open your defense, according to the court.
Mm-hmm.
The staff list from the presidency also makes it the front page of the paper.
The new crusading guide says MPP... the new weekend crusade. All these... it's just confusing, man. The MPP flag bearer race. Baumia is the man. That's one of the stories. And then also, there's a story here that says President submits annual report on staffing at presidency to parliament. And then something here about a chief somewhere in one of the parts of the country.
Finally, from me, the front page of the Inquisitor newspaper, they go with something we should take very seriously. Fear over police, military, frosty relations. Mm-hmm. They put it on the front page of their paper. Russian embassy in Accra accuses Kamala Harris of lies. And some news from Parliament. The MP for Yendi is now the chair for the Muslim caucus in Parliament.
Let me take you to the ABC News. Baumia must win, launched in grand style. Charlie, the people are partying hard. Also, let's prioritize fight against terrorism and violent extremism, according to our president. And China proposes global civilization initiative to strengthen cultural cooperation. And there's an editorial here that is talking about LGBT and related matters.
Okay, if you go online, citynewsroom.com says, we'll vote against government's new tax bills. That's coming from Mahama Ayariga. ECG releases nationwide doomsday timetable.
Yes.
Report on anti-gay bill laid before parliament.
Mm-hmm.
And Bank of Ghana says, CD bouquets hampers illegal. Stop it.
Yes.
So people have been warned. And Ekufado has over 1,000 staff at presidency. Those are some stories on citynewsroom.com. If you go to citybusinessnews.com, they say cuts international pushes for passage of competition bill. SEC says 5.5 billion CDs approved by Parliament, not only for Black Shield customers. And BOG assures of enhanced educational campaigns to ensure proper handling of local currency. If you go to other portals, majoronline.com, for instance, they have some stories on their front page, and they say political appointees at presidency increases to 361.
Mm.
Parliamentary committee recommends passage of controversial anti-LGBTQ bill. Kumasi Central Market traders disagree debt exchange program is responsible for stalled market redevelopment project. And ECG disconnects whole West Agoti Mesiope and South Dai District assemblies. Interesting, interesting, interesting stuff coming in. If you go to citysportsonline.com, they also have some stories. Of course, fans booing Keto Kriku and other ones there as well. And if you go international, the BBC has Donald Trump there.
Mm-hmm.
And it says, Trump to be charged over alleged payment to adult star. Oh, yes. So, and so those are that's the front page or the leading story on the BBC. They have Trump and several other ones there. And Paltrow cleared of fault over ski crash and awarded $1. At least that's what I see here. I forgot to give you the front page of the Herald.
Okay.
So I have a soft copy here. Mm-hmm. And it says MPP at crossroads to remove accounts only party tags.
Okay.
Cries Yendi MP years after his father's rejection by Kufuor and others. So for those who are wondering what the Herald's front page looks mm-hmm. like, that's what I just received. Plus in India, at least 35 killed in well collapse. In well collapse. That's a sad story coming in from India. Finally, Turkey approves Finland NATO membership bid.
Oh, look at them. Anyway, let me take you to the story about Dumso returning in, mm-hmm. in some shape or form, although Godfrey disagrees with my characterization.
There's Dumsi.
Okay, okay. Now, the story is on page 11, although the Ghanaian Times states that it's on page 14. Issue there. Jonathan Donko says that parts of the country are expected to experience interruptions in power supply for 14 days as the Ghana Gas Company Limited temporarily shuts down its Atuabo gas processing plant for maintenance. Now, according to the Ministry of Energy, the exercise started on Saturday. When completed, would ensure the reality of the reliability of the gas processing plant and transmission infrastructure in the country. Now, a statement issued by the Communications and Public Affairs Unit of the Ministry of Energy said the Electricity Company of Ghana is expected to release a schedule for the power supply interruptions. And if you go to some of the portals, the full, you know, schedule has been published.
Yes, yes. If you go to citynewsroom.com, for example,
yeah.
there's mm-hmm. a link where people can click
mm-hmm.
and check. Find the full schedule.
It's like checking your results.
Yeah, so check if your neighbor...
We'll get 5 hours off every
Every evening.
Every evening.
It's six p.m. to 11 p.m. At least that's what I saw.
Okay. All right. Let me. Well, staying with power situation, the power situation. The front page of the Daily Graphic. The independent power producers, the electricity generation companies that control 50% of the country's generation mix, have called on the government to urgently settle its indebtedness to them. The nine companies said the ECG owed them about the city equivalent of $1.4 billion as of last month. If the ECG does not pay up part of the debt owed our members, they cannot guarantee continuous production of power for the next 2 weeks.
But you see, they are not disconnecting the ECG. I've been very nice about it. But the ECG is
ECG has disconnection power.
Well, tell the people make one. Meanwhile, there's a story on page 3 of the Ghanaian Times that is disturbing. 1.2 million Ghana City power theft. Three ECG workers, seven others busted for stealing, and then also money laundering. Now, Malik Suleimana says three employees of the Electricity Company of Ghana who allegedly conspired with a vendor to manipulate the software of the company, resulting in power theft totaling 1.2 million Ghana cedis of prepaid credits, appeared before the High Court in Accra, charged with stealing and money laundering. Now, they are Ali Nancy Shaibu, a computer programmer at the ICT department, and he's at the head office. Grace Gardiner, hey, I know this name, chief supervising cashier of the ECG district office at Kasua, and Anthony D. K. Kwe, a technician at the ECG district office in Kasua. The others are Adamu, who is a technician at Ghana Electrometer Company, Muntari Adamu, Gariba Awudu, Kwesi Apia Donko, Eric Yaoche, and Agustina Laninyan, who are all private vendors who sold ECG prepaid power credit to the public. They have all pleaded not guilty to the charges. The point is that they are on trial, and then we'll see the full outcome of...
Let me take you to the Bank of Ghana, who are not very happy with how people are treating the city. On page 46 of the Daily Graphic, help keep city clean. The Bank of Ghana has called for concerted efforts to help keep the city banknotes clean for them to last longer. It said mishandling of the banknotes was a bad practice that led to a quicker defacing and spoilage of the notes, with implications on cost to the bank and the country as a whole. In that regard, Mr. Ozu also warned the general public to desist from using city banknotes as bouquets and hampers when gifting people. He said the bank had noticed that some people were using the city notes as bouquets and hampers as gifts during weddings, birthdays, and other celebrations. A practice, he said, that must be stopped.
Okay.
I see. Talking about money, if you go to citynewsroom.com, as a member of parliament for the Boku Central constituency, Mahama Yariga says the minority opposes the new revenue bills currently before parliament. He said the minority would vote against the bill when the time came, and Mr. Yariga indicated that unlike the approval of the ministerial nominees where a secret vote was used, a head count would be conducted to determine whether the new tax bills should be accepted or not, and that would help in the rejection of the bills. There's a
the Herald.
I just need to say that I think I read the wrong headline of the Herald, so we have the updated one.
Yeah, so the front page of the Herald this morning says rogue NDC MPs to redeem sunken image today with killer taxes rejection. The details on page 3 of the paper. Parliament is the place to be today, and the minority caucus is the group to watch. And that sounds like a football. As the members of parliament, after last Friday's appointment from the constitutional body to use its oversight responsibility to force the Akufo-Addo government to cut down the size of its government, the House expected to debate and pass three new revenue bills for the government to rake in four billion cedis per year. Now, the bills have been labeled killer taxes, as it is envisaged they will collapse businesses. And says that the NDC will oppose this.
It will go down to the wire. And let me take you back to Parliament, because there's a story here that says Parliamentary Committee recommends passage of controversial anti-LGBTQ bill. Now, the Constitutional and Legal Affairs Committee of Parliament, according to the Finder newspaper, has recommended that the House passes the controversial Proper Human Sexual Rights and Ghanaian Family Values Bill 2021. Now, according to the committee, a majority of Ghanaians are in favor of the legislation, While admitting that the bill had significant human rights concerns, the committee informed the House that it petitioned the Attorney General for his opinion. Now, the 18-page document, which was cited by the committee's chairperson, Kwame Anyimedu Entry, and then he goes on to tell Parliament that the House must pass the bill because, you know, in the view of the committee, overwhelming majority of Ghanaians are in support of the move to curtail such practices in our
country. Well, I think you also have the 361.
Yes. So that story is also on page two, although it screams on the front page of the paper. Elvis Dacko, the editor himself, writing this story, says the total number of political appointees working at the office of the president as of the end of 2022 numbered 361. Now, it goes on to say that two ministers of state, four senior presidential staffers make up the number. The number includes two ministers of state and four senior presidential staffers. Elvis Dacko, Abego, you know, the headlines, these, you know, bullet, what's the name? The sub-headlines you put inside, sometimes they are very confusing. You don't necessarily have to do it the way you sometimes do it. It's very, very confusing. You can't separate it from the real story. And he goes on to give you some other details and says the other political appointees at the office of the president number 315, bringing the number of political appointees to 361.
Okay. But in a related story, this is on citynewsroom.com, and it says a document submitted to Parliament by the office of the president has revealed that 1,048 staffers work at the presidency, serving various admin and domestic roles. The report submitted to Parliament is in accordance with Section 11 of the Presidential Office Act, Act 463. Okay. Now, the report covers three key areas, namely the number of presidential staff employed at the office of the president during the period, the ranks and grades of these staff, and employees of other public services assigned to the office of the president.
Yeah, I think yesterday Baumia sort of launched a campaign.
BMW.
Well, somebody is launching something forward on his behalf. So okay, you the have stories details, on a number of, what do you call it, front pages this morning. So for instance, if you go to page 9 of the Ghanaian Observer, the Go News Hound says that one of the fastest rising political volunteer groups in the ruling New Patriotic Party, known as Baumia Must Win, BMW, says the Vice President, Dr. Mahmoud Baumia, is a threat to the opposition National Democratic Congress. Hence the reason the NDC are always planting him black. Actually, they want to say painting him black to the public. There's some typo there. According to the group, the Vice President, Dr. Baumia, through the digitalization process has done a lot to make living for every Ghanaian very easy, which the NDC is not happy with, since he is standing tall among the other candidates that can lead the party to win the 2024 general elections. Now, the president of the group is Jesse Bako, and he said this during the launching of the BMW to throw their support behind Vice President Dr. Baumia as flag bearer hopeful of the party. So the launch was done at the Nat Hall in Accra yesterday. On the theme, making history with Dr. Baumia as the next president.
Was he there?
Of Ghana. Well, I'm not saying, you know.
But you know what's interesting? It's like one person wrote the story and distributed it, and the newspapers did not bother to edit.
Oh, Charlie.
So the story that Observer has
is the same story.
Word for word is the story the New Weekend Crusade in Ghana has. It's the same story that. It's okay.
If you're,
all right. Let me tell you.
Spoiling the professional.
Let me tell you about. Maybe it's the same ownership. Who knows or something.
Oh no. Charlie.
Yeah. Well. So the Inquisitor. I'll give you two quick stories from the Inquisitor and wrap up. The Inquisitor says that the clash between the military and the police in Accra was a serious breach. This is coming from Emmanuel Kutin. He believes that it is time that the military focuses on this commission. Get that one. And my final story is that the size of your banku should be determined by your fist. nutritionist. All foods constitute the majority. Ball foods constitute the majority of foods consumed by most Ghanaians. Uh-huh. The number of balls consumed is mostly determined by one's appetite for the day or how delicious the food tastes. Uh-huh. A nutritionist, however, Fozia Bedu, has urged Ghanaians to consume appropriate portions of carbohydrates in their diet. Uh-huh. According to her, the size of Ghanaian ball foods like banku, kenki, tozafi, and fufu should be determined by one's fist.
Really?
Quote, your fist size should be your guide, she said on the GTV breakfast show.
Over that, if you have Violella, if you are small cat, you can't small man.
Beverly Landing will eat. Beverly Landing, good morning. Oh,
anyway,
she will eat fufu.
Anyway, just a quick one from the United States. Now, the BBC is breaking a story. It says Donald Trump is said to be the first former president to face criminal charges. New York prosecutors have been investigating the payment of hush money to an adult film star prior to his election in 2016. Okay, now the lady says she was paid $130,000 to keep quiet. The payment itself was legal, but Trump allegedly recorded it as a business expense. And in New York, falsifying business records is illegal, and Trump is expected to appear in court to face the charges and enter a plea in New York next
week. How many
Tuesday.
Times has the U.S. government itself, through the CIA and these many operatives, not bribed foreign governments around the world? All kinds of things.
Is it recorded as a business transaction?
No.
It's not.
Charlie, your old friend Tuli has made it to the front page. She's in Accra.
Oh, I see.
See, they captured her attending something with Professor Boko.
Oh, powerful, okay.
Okay. Must go and find you.
All right, Godfred and Richard, thank you. That was the newspaper review. Coming up next is the City Business News.
Ah, you know your papa see that? And his rickety car. Hey, papa!
Bobo!
Papa!
Ah, Bobo, so how's your engine now?
It is half man, half amazing. Thanks to Quartz and you. Come feel better energy.
Thank you. Tax Force of Customs King Godfred Akoligle. The Vice Chancellor of the University of Ghana, Professor Nana Aba Apia Amfo, has added her voice to calls for global financial development agencies to prioritize investment avenues which is geared towards achieving the Sustainable Development Goals. According to her, bilateral development financiers remain crucial to the success of narratives of economies around the world. Speaking at the DBG UGBS Development Finance Dialogue Series in Accra, Professor Nana Aba Apia Amfo urged stakeholders within the financial space to help achieve the SDG targets by 2030.
The global economic outlook is in serious flux. Getting our financing right will be critical to meet the SDGs by 2030. Domestic public finance and international development cooperation nevertheless remain central for the achievement of the SDGs. Bilateral development financiers are a growing force in global development, with combined portfolios now worth more than $84 billion. Currently, however, the global financial system is not channeling these vast sums effectively towards investments for sustainable development and for achieving the SDGs. Many private sector actors and development finance institutions, such as DBG, are leading the way and investing in the SDGs under innovative categories like sustainable finance or ethical investments to accelerate inclusive and sustainable economic transformation.
That was the Vice Chancellor of the University of Ghana, Professor Nana Aba Apia Amfo. Now on the interbank foreign exchange markets, where banks trade amongst themselves, the dollar remained unchanged and is selling at 11 cedis 2 pesos. The British pound is selling at 13 cedis 6 pesos. It recorded no price change. The euro gained 3 pesos and is selling at 12 cedis 2 pesos. However, at some forex bureaus within the capital, the dollar is going for 12 cedis 10 pesos, while the British pound is going for 14 cedis 80 pesos and the euro for 13 cedis. Let's now join Gillian Hammer of Data Bank for more on the topic, the fundamentals of financial planning, why you should pay yourself first.
When it comes to your money, earning it is only half the battle. Once you've got a balance in your bank account, putting a plan in place to manage, save, and invest it is crucial to your long-term financial well-being. Most people spend their money and then say, oh, I need to save. Then at the end of the month, they just forget and they never really save. Set aside a percentage of every paycheck and put the money into a separate account as soon as you are paid. Most people get caught up paying their bills once their paycheck comes in, and they end up with very little to save. By being disciplined and paying yourself first, you will force yourself to live off less than your total paycheck. Note, however, that paying yourself first can work against you if you have high interest or bad debt. If the interest rate on your loans is higher than what you will get on your investments, consider paying off your loans as quickly as possible first, so you don't end up working against yourself.
That was Juliet Hammer of Data Bank. And that does it for the breakfast edition of City Business News, proudly brought to you by MTN, Goal and powered by your most comprehensive business news website, citybusinessnews.com. My name is Netele Nete Ajahu. Have a good business day.
If home is where the heart is, then let's go home, shall we?
Thank you.
first, a few things you need to know. Easter Monday is on the 10th of April. And so join Rockstar and Lewin at the Ifa Sutherland Children's Park to witness the biggest fanfare and playground. Get your tickets for only 5 CDs. Indomie Fest this year is packed with lots of fun activities, food, and exciting performances. Come join us with your family and friends. Let's have fun. Powered by TikTok and Lynx Entertainment. Now, galamse is not a good thing. It's poisoned our rivers with mercury and cyanide, and it's caused rampant deforestation, and is also causing the loss of good drinking water. Now, if you want to mine, there are responsible mining methods under the National Alternative Employment and Livelihood Program that you can sign on to. Respect the laws of Ghana. Help protect the future of our children. This message has been powered by the Ministry of Lands and Resources and the Minerals Commission of Ghana. Imagine how the power to impact the world around you. At the British Council, they see students from all over the world with dreams of a bright future coming together for a quality education that achieves goals. Those who study abroad in countries like the UK are getting much more than just a degree. They are getting a world of valuable experiences. Visit the British Council website to find out how you can own your future. Coming up next is the City Business Edition. Today we interact with some vendors who were at the Back to Your Village Food Bazaar to find out what their experiences were. They'll talk about the patronage, and then they'll, you know, share some feedback on the entire show or the entire program, you know, highs and lows, lessons learned, and all of that. Of course, all of this is to wrap up our conversation around making it Ghana in our Heritage Month, be it tourism, investment, film, anything, make it Ghana. So we are giving the platform to producers of local food, domestic meals, Ghanaian meals, authentic Ghanaian meals, to talk about how it went for them at the Back to Your Village Food Bazaar.
This is the City Breakfast Show, the city's biggest conversation.
Please wait. Please wait. Please wait until I get my new car. Please wait until I find my real size. I'm gonna get me some love from somebody. My girl, sweet girl, my girl, I can see.
Hello there, and welcome to another episode of the City Business Edition here on 97.3 City FM. My name is Michael Obudu. Thank you for tuning in. And you know, over the past month, we've been on a Heritage Month celebrating everything Ghana. But you know, here at City FM and City TV, we are taking the conversation beyond just the month of March, but we are championing our Make It Ghana campaign based on the three legs of tourism, investment, and film. But yeah, let's talk about the Back to Your Village Food Bazaar, which happened at the Accra Metropolitan Assembly Forecourt over the weekend on Saturday and Sunday. If you weren't there, you missed out big time. But anyways, I have in studio with me three exhibitors who were there to showcase some of their local foods. I'll let them introduce themselves and then we'll delve straight into the conversation. So you're all welcome to the show.
Thank you, Michael.
Thank you, Michael.
Awesome. So I'll start with you. Please tell us your name and what you deal in.
Okay, my name is Victoria Nakai Abense and I make local snacks. My brand name is Crunchy Local Snacks. We are into Nkati Cake, Kube Cake, Adunle, Achomo, Plantain Chips, etc.
Nice. We'll talk about the Achomo bit. That's one of my favorites. Chief, what about you, sir?
Yeah, so my name is Pakweku. We are into Gherkin K. So they're very succulent Gherkin K and succulent and nice spicy fried pork.
Oh.
We have octopus, we have shrimps, we have fish, and we have the drink section where we call it crackets. So it's a combination of coconut juice and fresh palm wine.
It just made me hungry.
Every day.
Is your pork fried or grilled?
we have the fried and we have the grilled option.
Charlie, we have to talk after here. What about you, ma?
Yes, so I'm Linda Kanko from TZHQ. We are into local Ghanaian meals. Precisely, we do fufu, bankun, tubani, kokonte, tozafi, dawadawa, jollof, all the Ghanaian local meals you can think of.
I see.
Very tasty and very healthy meals. Yeah, during the City Bazaar, we always concentrate on the Nordic meals, which are the dawadawa jollof rice, the tozafi. Yes, you should. It's very, very nice.
We have
tubani, yes. And my usual tozafi. I have the millet tozafi and then the corn tozafi. I don't think you've tried the millet tozafi before.
First time I'm actually hearing of it.
Yeah, you should. It's very, very delicious and very, very nice too.
Wow.
Yes, and then I also have the local beverages. I have the Zonkom, I have the Asana, the Sobolo, the Pito from the north. Wow. Yes, all the way from the north. You should give us a try.
Your house would be a very interesting one.
Yes.
Anyway, so let me find out from you, how and where did you hear about the Food Bazaar and if this is your first time participating? So.
Okay, so I'm a City person. So obviously, I heard it from City FM. And I was on this year's Heritage Caravan as well.
Oh, yes. Well, then you are a city alumni through and through.
True and true. But last year, I came to pass through not as a vendor.
Okay.
And then this year, I came as a vendor. It was good.
Wow.
I'll come again.
I like that. So how old is your business? Just
a year.
Oh, wow.
A year and a few months.
Fantastic. We'll get to know how this fair has helped you and you tell us all the progress you've made so far. Chief, Guy Kinke, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes. No, so tell me about your Gakeke festival. Is it wearing school uniform or something? How different is your Gakeke and what's on?
Charlie, it is a very typical Gakeke that you know.
Okay.
But we give it a bit of a touch where, I mean, she says her food is healthy. Mm-hmm. I mean, we are helping you treat your stress and all your headaches. So with this, I mean, and you know how our typical Gakeke are very soft and it fits perfectly with the proteins that it comes with, the spicy pork and then the octopus and the rest of them all. Yeah.
Where are you located again?
So we're in Achalewo Tree.
Achalewo for talk.
You for come.
When you're speaking about soft kinky.
You for come.
You've got me. What about you though?
Yes, so I'm a city person.
Okay.
My husband, every morning the dial is on 97.3 at home.
Okay.
And when I'm driving, my dial is always on city. Hmm. So in 2020, I heard about the bazaar.
Wow.
And I decided to take part.
Okay.
And I never regretted it.
Wow.
Yes, it opened a lot of doors, a lot of orders, a lot of referrals. And since then, yes, I've always been monitoring when it is every year. Hey, as soon as I know, yes, I know we are moving into the month of March.
Wow.
You know, I'm monitoring.
Interesting. But how old is your business though?
Yeah, so I started in 2019.
Okay.
Yes, so okay. 4 years now.
So you have been at all our food bazaars?
Yes. Yes, since 2020.
What has the experience been like for you?
Yes, I think it has been very, very great. I think every year it's been overwhelming. Mm. There's always an improvement over the last one.
Okay.
In terms of demand, in terms of orders,
wow.
Yes, in terms of sales. It's always been amazing.
Fantastic.
Yes.
Fantastic. I'm sure by the time we'll be done, you will all tell us what the general perception is about local foods.
Yeah.
Like, because from what you're saying, means that the demand really is there.
Yes. Yes, because...
Demand is there.
Yeah.
But I think now people are looking for spaces they can eat and be comfortable in.
Wow.
So the demand for the local food is there.
Mm-hmm.
But you see, sometimes you get it at some very not so clean places and stuff like
Seriously.
That.
Seriously.
And some can't also make it at home.
True.
Yeah.
True.
So when there's an event like that, and there are places also like TZ headquarters and other people that deliver like mine, you can't come to my place to sit and have snacks.
Sure.
So I deliver to you. Mm-hmm. You would want to eat kati cake, but the kati cake seller you see in traffic.
Oh, Charlie.
You know,
the sweat crowd puts you off.
The sweat crowd puts you off. So my kati cake is packaged nicely.
Oh, wow.
I put it in a pouch.
Okay.
And once you see it, the appeal is there for you to want to try it.
Hmm.
So I think the demand is there, but we just need to level up a bit and meet the demands of the people.
Kati Cake is educated. Yeah. Can you imagine?
And I even have a brain in Kati.
Oh, I see.
Yes.
Oh, yes. You are my friend.
And I also noticed, you know, COVID-19, there has been a shift, you know.
Okay.
People were looking out for meals that were healthy, you know, because of the virus at the time.
True.
Meals that will boost the immune system.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so for me, that was when I started business.
Wow.
And that was when I realized there was a high demand for the local meals. Because, for instance, if you take the ayoyo, which is the jute leaves,
it
contains a lot of ions, a lot of proteins, you know, so a lot of folate. And even, it's even good for lactating mothers.
I see.
Yes, and then it helps in delaying the aging of the skin, yes, cells and all that. Yes, the jute leaves.
Hey.
Yes. So you realize that from COVID-19, there's been a shift. You know, Ghanaians were more into concentrating on healthy, you know, local meals and all that. So I think from that time, that was where the shift, the paradigm, you know, shifted towards the Ghanaian local meals. And I think I've actually taken advantage of that.
Wow.
Yes, and I think it's something that we need to market to, not just because it's an immune booster or maybe because COVID is around or something. No, but it's something that is healthy and it's something that we should be consistent. You know, at the end of the day, it's the general well-being of the human being that we are looking at.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Chief, what about you? Is this your first time at the food bazaar?
Yes, yes, yes. It's my first time. So, Michael, I mean, to add to what the two ladies have said, you know, our local meals are not fast foods.
Sure.
And a lot of people wanted or want the fast meals. Mm-hmm. I mean, they go to Burger King, they just grab a bite and then they are
they're
gone.
They're good to go.
But like she has said, I mean, following from the events of COVID-19, the lockdowns and the rest, people were beginning to take, give some attention to their health and what they eat. So yes, that has become the reason why people are shifting towards they're very old. I mean, it's a Sankofa Yenchi. So they've just gone back to what it is. Yes, so this is our first time we were at the food bazaar. We watched it live on TV last year.
I see.
And we saw the jamboree, the fanfare.
Nobody does it like City does.
Yeah.
See? And it was like, Chief, why didn't you go there? We said, mark it on the calendar. Next year, we are there.
Wow.
And we are forever going to be there.
Awesome.
Yes.
Awesome.
For till City is tired of food bazaar.
Yeah, we are not tired anytime soon. So tell me on the day, what was the demand like? What were the interactions with the customers, everything? Tell me about the whole experience.
Okay, so, you know, like, unlike Linda, who has been there before, for us, we were just... we're just anxious.
Okay.
How is it all going to look like? Because it was 11:12 and business was a little low. I don't know about Linda.
Yes, on the first day.
On the first day, business was a little low.
The weather too wasn't very clear.
And one of my colleagues were like, Chale, Adiebe. And I said, Nyabuche. Adebesano.
Sharp.
What is ours would come to us.
You're a big man.
And by 2 p.m., I mean, people were just trooping in, and the moment they got there, it was food for them.
Yeah.
Sharp.
No dawdling. It was straight to the food.
Yeah.
So the demand started at about 2 p.m. And it never ended.
Wow.
Even when your colleague, Nana Tufo, had signaled that the day was over. I mean, people were still trooping in. And I think the minister's presence also also did some magic.
Yeah.
Because
Fantastic.
Just after he left, I mean, it was like a double of whatever had happened in the previous hours. So it was great. I mean, for us, the demand was for the pork and the octopus.
Wow.
I'm like, there's kinky, there's fish. And one man said, kinky is a very regular thing. I mean, our next door vendor is selling kinky.
Yeah.
But our next door vendor is not selling pork or octopus. So Charlie give us some octopus and then some pork. And I mean, that was it. And it was fantastic. It was amazing.
But that was a very sharp combination you did there. Brand association. Interesting. But you know, I was very fascinated with the numbers on Sunday.
That's true.
It literally looked like a marketplace.
Yes.
How did you guys deal with all those numbers?
Yeah, so because I've been attending, so I knew Sundays is always the double of the crowd that usually come on their Saturdays. So I prepared ahead.
Nice.
Yes. So for instance, if you come on the Saturday, you have to plan ahead to ensure that your Sunday you double or triple whatever you have. Because my husband had to go back to the restaurant like two or three times to bring more teas.
Seriously.
To our stand. Yeah, so that tells you the greatness of this bazaar.
Fantastic. Yeah. Well, what about you, though?
I think so, too. I think the Sunday, the numbers were overwhelming.
Hmm.
It looked like three or four festivals combined.
Seriously.
There were so many people, and the sun was hot, but people were not perturbed.
I was surprised.
And at a point, the food people were moving there. You could see their stands were full.
Okay.
So they carried the food and they are looking for a place to sit.
Wow.
Find someone. Oh, madam. Can I sit here? Oh, I'm like, oh, yes, fine. Why not? Sit behind. Because I was a heritage caravan, my bus members, shout outs to bus 2 members, Team Ed, they came to set up a whole party behind
our
canopy. The chairs went. Sunday was overwhelming.
Seriously.
I think all 2 days it was good. It was good.
But Sunday, particular, even after 7 p.m.,
people were
trying still, to close.
Yeah.
But I could see people still.
Now I heard somebody say, hey, vendors, won't you close for us to go home?
Amazing.
So that tells you city should extend it.
We'll try.
Yes. You have to consider that.
But Michael, you were relating it to a marketplace.
Sure.
But of course, Makola is just close by.
I'm sure
some people were probably driving and they were like, what's going on here? Let me just park
it. I tell you.
I think what makes the Sunday bits, more exciting is that, you know, Saturdays people attend their social events, their weddings, funerals, and the rest.
And they
are listening to it on CT and they are missing out on the fun. And they don't want to miss any of it any longer. So, Sunday, I think by 8 a.m., people have started trooping in.
It was already busy.
And you know, if you don't do Sunday, you have to wait a whole year.
That's true.
Yes.
And I like the after church people.
Yeah.
Right after church, people started.
They were amazing.
Wow.
They were amazing.
After church,
with their kids
Sunday
and their
still
church.
Started you know? From like 8 a.m. By 9 a.m., people had already started on Sunday. But
and people were there in their church attire.
Yes. I mean, after church, people only did it.
A man left his Bible on my table. He left his Bible and his hymn on my table.
The food must have been that good.
So we had to wait, skip it somewhere. He came back. He came back with 4 of his friends.
Fantastic.
He had even forgotten his Bible was there.
Oh, Charlie.
He brought his friends to come and eat.
Oh.
And then I said, sir, you left your Bible and your human.
Fantastic.
No, but honestly, that calls for an extension because I had a lot of customers.
Okay.
My food, for instance, on Sunday got finished at around 3 p.m.
Wow.
Yes, even with the numerous trips from the stands to the restaurant to and fro and all that. So there were a lot of complaints. Oh, we came all the way.
Oh.
Dawa Dawa Jollof is finished. Oh, Tozaf is finished. Oh, we came all the way to Bani. Some were not happy. But I believe it's if city consider